Welcome back, fellas. In today's video, I will install modification module with SI4732 chip to this Quansheng UVK5 radio to unlock full band capability. Mode kit came in this bag, PCB with chip, small capacitors and resistor. Well, I should start. All products, including mode kit, are linked in description below. UVK5 doesn't use screws to hold radio together. Not even this nut is holding it. You can disassemble radio by praying here below the battery place. Now, I will gently separate radio in two pieces. Oh well, speaker is soldered directly to the board. This plastic frame fell out. Let's desolder two speaker cables so that we can walk freely. Done. Mode PCB will sit here, replacing this chip and few other components. Kit contains resistor, 5 pieces of small capacitors, but we only need one, so 4 are spare ones. And PCB board with SI4732 chip and some other components already on the board. So it should be located here, like so. This small PCB offcut can be removed. One more look and I'll start. Display has to be flipped, so unclick and let it rest like so. Here we have to remove this component and solder on that resistor from the kit. This is the easiest part. Resistor can sit right here, so let's make more space by removing the screw. All will be fine, that screw is not needed. I'll shape terminals of the resistor and solder it on like so. One leg on negative and another leg on hot or live point. Next to the original component, done. Next step is to replace this level capacitor with one provided in the kit. Thanks God they included 5 pieces. This thing is so small that you can't even see terminals properly. Let me fix pads and get out one of the new ones. Oops, already dropped it. Oh boy, it is so tiny. At least that's what she said. Alright, enjoy my struggle. I think it is on. Let me wiggle test it. Looks good. Let's see it under loop. Not the prettiest, but it is there. Next job is to remove these two components. They just need to be removed, that's all. Make sure to subscribe or else your radio won't turn on anymore. Done. Let's move on removing this 8-legged chip. Easiest is to gently cut legs off close to the chip and remove body of the chip, then desoldering legs one by one, just like so. Leave a comment with what do you think is the hardest part of this mod. Let's check, looks good, so test fit PCB and I'll stick double-sided tape on bottom side to help holding PCB on its place. Let's try to align it properly. Boom, it's on. Ground need to be connected. Next chip terminals. And these two terminals. Let's wait for those. Now I'll solder on ground this large ground plate. Should be enough. And now I'll connect 6 of the old chip terminals to the new PCB. It can be done using solder only. Just connect 3 on one side and 3 on another side. Alignment is straightforward, easy. Now these two terminals have to be done with jumper wire. As bottom one has to be connected to far side of this little white resistor, cut rest of the wire, and top terminal has to be connected to the top side of this little black capacitor. At this point I can't even see if I'm doing right thing, but let's hope it will turn okay. And surprise surprise, all is fine and connected. Make sure to double check your walk and display can go back in. Just clicks on. I'll test radio if it's still working. So battery in and power on. Well, still works. Let's solder on speaker wires and tighten antenna nut. put on leather frame for connectors, and assemble the radio like so. Slide it in and press button until it clicks. Test all buttons, fit power / volume knob, and antenna can be screwed on. Lastly, battery. Another test fully assembled. All works. Perfect. Now, let's flash custom firmware for modded Quencheng UVK5 with SI4732 chip. By the way, all links are in description. I'm using Exoma Web Flasher to flash CEC041HF firmware. Once all done, radio is ready to turn on. Here, CEC041HF firmware. Let's access sub 30 MHz receiving menu by holding 0 button. And here, all magic happens. You can change modulation by holding F button. I cannot show you much as I don't have antenna for these frequencies. So all we gonna hear is static noise. But I can show you that we can go low as 150 kHz. It is nuts. So let me fill in my gaps on these frequencies and also build some antennas to test this properly. Until then, stay tuned. And good luck with your soldering. Thanks for watching and see you next time.